A $12 billion cash boost in next week's budget will go towards fixing the country's housing crisis. As new research out today reveals stark figures for those wanting to buy a home. Let's head live with more to today. Queensland reporter Ash and Krukelis in Brisbane. Ash, hello again. Where's this money going?
Clint, this is a major investment and there are a few parts to it. Treasurer Jim Chalmers says in order to address our housing shortage, we need to boost supply. So $1 billion will go towards encouraging private home construction. The money will be given to states and territories to be spent on new roads and services that are needed for new builds. A further $1 billion will go towards helping women and children fleeing domestic violence. And then the largest portion, $9.3 billion, will go towards a five-year plan to tackle homelessness. So the money will be spent on building and repairing social housing. Now, this comes as new figures from Finder show just how hard it is for young people to afford a home. Have a look at this. For someone who's just left school in Brisbane or Melbourne, it's likely to take them 21 years to afford the 20% deposit for the current median house price. For someone in Sydney, double that and add some, 46 years. Of course, units are an easier entry point, but they're still difficult. For an 18-year-old here in Brisbane, it's likely to take them a decade to afford the 20% deposit of the median unit price, 18 years for someone in Sydney. Finder says it is becoming a pipe dream for Gen Z to buy a home, and that is why, of course, this is one of the major issues the federal government is targeting in this week's budget. Clint?
Time now for Weekend Today Property Watch. More and more first home buyers are now rent vesting. So it's this notion of giving them a chance to get into the property market without actually having to move away from the comfort of their rental.
For more on this, we're joined by Domain property editor Alice Stoltz in Melbourne. Morning, Alice. Just how popular is this now?
Good morning, guys. Well, look, it's certainly increasing at the moment as we've seen many first home buyers really battling these rising home buyer prices at the moment. Basically, the idea is you can have the best of both worlds. You can live where you want to live, but you've still got an investment property that's hopefully making money for you that you'll reap the rewards of in the long run.
Alice, I dare say there might be a but. What should people be aware of?
Look, I think you have to really think of yourself as becoming an investor. So you don't want to really max out what you're going to borrow from the bank. The bank will probably offer you a lot of money to borrow, but you can't because you obviously are paying rent at the same time. So really think, how much can I afford? Do your research. Look where those vacancy rates are record low, and we're seeing them all around the country now. So look forensically and ensure the areas you're looking at are not going to, you know, be a dud area. You need to have infrastructure and one that's got good capital growth. And ultimately, think about this, you know, head over heart. You cannot be emotional. Stay detached from this.
Which is hard.
Presumably, too, if you're on a first homeowner type budget, there are certain areas, like sort of suburbs, I guess, that you should look for.
That's exactly right, Jane. So what we've got today is looking at data that basically looks at affordable entry-level areas that also offer a decent rental yield. So you can see in Melbourne and Sydney that yield is, you know, not as good as what it is in areas like Adelaide, Perth and Brisbane. So you want to yield around 5% ideally if you're going to be a rent vester as a first home buyer. Areas like Lowood in Brisbane yield nearly 6%. Sydney, you can see that yield drops to 4.2%. But Adelaide, 401,000 yield of 6%, and Perth is the best market in the country to become a rent vester in, 476,000, and that yield is 7.43%. And a lot of people are rent vesting in different states, but you really need to ensure you know that market well. So research is absolutely key here.